Right, this week on AutoResTomod, we're doing drum brakes for Ford applications. But before we go into that, why don't you do yourself a favor and look for the Whataburger tent card somewhere within the confines of the episode after the National Parts Depot ad. If you see the Whataburger tent card somewhere in the episode, do yourself a favor and write into us at the address below, and you will be registered to win a BF Goodrich t-shirt. So write in, get a shirt.
Brought to you by Eaton Detroit Spring, proudly made in the USA. Also brought to you by BF Goodrich Tires, who asks, are you driver enough?
Right now, we show you how to do a clean install on Ford rear drum brakes on a 1969 Fairlane station wagon.
National Parts Depot is proud to offer these alloy wheels for your classic Ford. The wheels offer clean, original styling, while sizes from 15x7 to 17x8 inch allow for a greater selection in modern performance tires. Check out National Parts Depot for Mustang and Cougar, Camaro and Firebird, Chevelle and GTO, Ford Truck and Bronco, Chevy Truck, Mopar, and Thunderbird. At our four locations, we stock the largest selection of classic car parts anywhere. Visit us at nationalpartsdepot.com or call us at 888-893-FAST.
We don't know where Cam's at. We got a lot to do this week on the brakes. Great. Yellow. What do you mean you hurt your ankle? Like, is it big and swollen up? Can you just, I don't know, like wrap it or something? All right, well, I'll just take care of this alone then. No big deal. Yep. Yeah, fine. Just take care of your ankle, man. Bye. Right. So, I guess I'm alone this week. Yay. Anyway, so now that I've got that out of the way, what we did here is this. Now, normally you would not take the axle out to do the brake system on these classic cars because you don't need to. It's not that big a deal. But what I wanted to do is to be able to give you guys a good view of what goes on when you take it off. So I've gone in and just put some washers and the nuts back on here temporarily so that I can install the drum brakes, show you how everything goes on, and then basically kind of go from there. All right, now one of the first things I want to mention on this that a lot of guys ignore completely on these classic car brake systems, especially with them being well over 40 years old on most of these cars, is these pads right here that go around the perimeter of the backing plate. These pads are very important, and that's because your shoes rest on these. If these have got dimples and runs in it like you're seeing in the footage I'm showing you right now, if they have those kind of dimples and runs in there, you're going to end up having the rear brakes where they kind of chunk into position and they're not deploying as they should. So what you need to do is to go in and weld these things up and grind them smooth so that these areas are nice and flat. Now what I'll do is I'll weld them, I'll grind them with an air grinder, and then go in and use a piece of steel with 80 or 60 grit initially, then 80 grit sandpaper to get these nice and smooth so that the brakes have a nice place to rest whenever you're putting everything back together. And when you're going down the road, the brakes will actually operate the way they're supposed to. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna go over to the table and talk to you about some of the parts that are and aren't available. All right, so what I've got here on the table are the two things. We have the stuff that we kept from off of the 69 Fairlane and the stuff we're adding. This is a basic brake kit. I just got this because the springs are nicely painted. It's gonna look better on camera for you guys. Not necessarily because I needed the components, because the ones that were in there actually looked pretty good for condition. But these will be nice and shiny for you to look at. Now these are the parts that we retained off of the 69 Fairlane. We're gonna reuse these because basically they're in really good shape and they're not consumable items, with the exception of this spring, which you can get in some of the kits from National Parts Depot. Everything else here looks good. The wire's not frayed and in good condition, so we used what we could off of the car. So I'm gonna grab all this stuff up, get over there and get started on it. Well, I'll get it in a minute. All right, we're gonna start putting the brakes on the car now, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put on my safety glasses, because what I'm fixing to start working with is brake clean, and this stuff can get in your eyes and cause some damage. Always wear gloves, highly important for what you're doing, because you wanna keep this as clean as you possibly can. And what I'm gonna tell you right now is something Bill pointed out the other day, is to always clean your gloves before you start working. I'm gonna spray some brake clean in my cloth here. and I'm going to show you why. I've just kind of been sitting down here on the floor, wiping around on things absent-mindedly, not really paying any attention to what I'm doing with that. And by Gumby, what do you know? I pulled that much dirt off of the gloves before I do my brake job. So that's something important to do. And just leave your glasses on, because there's going to be parts that you're going to be doing that are going to be flying around. Now, your next order of business here is shoes. I want to talk to you about this real quickly, because there is some confusion with folks out here in the hobby about what shoe goes where. Now, basically, on a Ford drum brake system, your long shoe, which has brake surface from the bottom corner back here to the top, goes on the back, and your short shoe, it goes on the front. First thing to know. I'm going to install this, but I've got to do some things first, because this is a rear brake system. So I'm going to take these out of the way for the moment. All right, I'm going to pull my nasty emergency brake cable back into play here and put it back in line on the cart. It's kind of like wrestling a snake in a way. Now that's back in there and ready to go. I'm going to clean my gloves again. So I got the dirt from that on there. And you'll probably want to do this several times whenever you're working on your brake system on your car. And we're going to put our pins in. This is basically what deploys your brake. This is a hydraulic cylinder, and these pins push out. I'm going to put these in here. Try to put them in at the same time, otherwise you may push the piston out of the other side of this. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and put our emergency brake actuator back on this arm. And these things can be an absolute pain. I've taken my gloves off because I want to go in and get this thing, and it's a lot harder to do than it might look, because this thing can be very persnickety about not wanting to fall back enough for you to get it on there, and it can bite you, which it just bit me. There. Okay, it's just a lot easier to hang that on there that way than it is to do another way. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little dab of grease around here. I'm not going to put a ton, because I don't want it to get out here on the actual shoes, but I do want a little bit on here for mobility. And a little bit on the pads. I'm going to put my shoe on here. And this goes in here. And there's a C-clip that goes on there as well. A lot of times you'll have to take and start the C-clip with the mechanics pliers and then spin it and close these off. Now that's set. This is going to sit like this. I'm going to put my pin in across the back. It loads from the back side of it through there. Now the exciting part is putting all of this together, because what you have to do is you have a spring cup here and the spring. This goes and inserts on here. And you kind of have to hold all of this in position and hold your mouth just right. And you have to load. Realistically, you should have three hands doing this. Some creature from the Star Trek series. And you have to load the other cap into your spring tool with the extra hand you don't have and spin it into position while you're holding these in place. And it's just a pain in the butt. Yay! Once you get it, you got it. So that's that side. Now I'm going to make sure that my gloves are all clean, and we'll move to the front side. But there's probably a couple of different ways people will do this. And this is why I want you to wear gloves, because you're going to be pawing these shoes for a little while. Okay. You're trying to get the stuff to seat in. All right, first thing to go on is this diamond-shaped piece that's there to hold the plates together, keep them lined up. Next thing to go on is your wire. This is going to need to go back behind here and tie into the next piece to go on, which is your wire loom or run. That goes in there. In the hole. Then you have your spring, which inserts inside of this, rolls around, and hopefully, if I do this right, will attach to the plate. and hold all that in position. Now I'm going to put my parking brake link in. The parking brake link sits like this, with this piece facing the front, with the spring in the front section, and it goes in like this. And then I've got a spring that goes in a cross line on it that attaches all that together. I'm using the blue one because that's just how it works. Careful not to pinch yourself when you're doing this. Okay, we're looking pretty good now. All right, the next thing is your adjuster. All right, now when you're putting the adjuster screw in, you have to make sure that you have same. You have a right one and a left one. Make sure you put this piece on the right side of the car. It's always marked inside of here, right or left. And same thing with the stop. It's also marked with an R or an L. So when you get this stuff and put it together, make sure you do that. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and put that in. And basically you wanna make sure when you're putting this in that the adjuster is actually sitting like this and deploying it. And you'll need to adjust these out once you get the drums in there. But you'll wanna set this in here. All right, the next thing you wanna do is you wanna put the adjuster piece in. That's this thing right here. It sits right there and it keeps the adjuster wheel from actually turning once it's been set. You literally have to go in with a brake spoon, this item right here, and push on this part of it to get it to pull out so you can actually turn this and make it work. It's a lot of fun to do. On there, this sits in that hole, and then this installs here like so. And I always use a vice grip to do this because it's a little easier to get it to put into play. Let me push this to there, pull that to there, and there you go. You have your drum brakes back on here. Now we'll do a shoe set to make sure this is going to work after we put our axle back on here, which I'm going to do off camera because it's not part of the brake job. All right, I'm gonna clean up the drums now. Be careful with this. I normally would just spray these out, but we've got paint on the outside of this and the brake clean will absolutely chew into that paint. I'm sure I should probably use something different than a paper towel to do this, but I'll use a little bit of compressed air after I've cleaned the drum out to get all the debris out of the inside of here. Okay, that's what the inside of that drum looked like. Not good. It shouldn't be that dirty. I mean, it should because of the cosmoline down in there, but or whatever they use for that. It would contaminate your shoes for sure. All right, got my air in and hooked up. Not gonna touch the inside of the drum again. So I'm gonna pull my drum up into my lap, keep it up off the floor, get all the junk out of it. It's got to be clean air. If it's not clean air, it could cause you a problem. Make sure you got a separator between your air hose line and your final line. Otherwise, it could be some small amount of oil that comes out of the end of the gun and contaminates your surface. So I'm going to put this on and see what we got here. It's perfect because it's loose. You'll have to go in and do an adjustment with the adjuster on the back side of the drum here, but this looks really good. We got a good even lay across all of it. Once the wheel gets on there, it'll pull it into position. But as I spin it, I don't hear anything that sounds like I've got a warped drum or the shoes are not sitting in the right place. So that's good to go. Right, so we got these in here and it's all ready to go on this side. I'll need to go and do the other side, but we're not going to show you that because it's the same thing just on the other side of the car. So that's how you install these. Now adjusting them is fairly straightforward and easy according to the Ford manual. You would take the car out, drive it onto a flat surface, go forward and then back up, forward, back up, applying about 50 pounds of pressure to the brakes. And that should, if your adjusters and everything are properly greased, make the brakes work just fine and you should be good to go. We, however, have other things to do on this car. We've got to put a brake line in here because I don't like the way our originals are looking. There's a lot of rust inside of them. So we're going to replace those with some classic tube lines. Next, we're going to show you what we do with that. And then we'll show you also how to bleed down a classic car braking system. And then maybe, if we have time, we'll go ahead and go out and show you how to adjust the rear brakes. But until then, come back and watch us next time on Auto Resto Mod. Have a great week, folks. Brake drums.
Quiet on set, and he came in with that nose ding.
With a nose ding.
Stop looking at me like that. I don't like the way he's looking at me.
He's looking at you because you got a nose dingling.
Obviously.
Stop looking at me that way.
I'm gonna be like that.
My nose is not that big. It's my muscles you should fear.
That was an Arnold Schwarzenegger accent.
I'm sorry, it's all I can do.
This is going behind the scenes.
Let's hope so. Way behind the scenes. All right, you guys ready?
Yep.